Hi there, this is Jessica. This is a video I've been wanting to make for a while, ever since I posted my last video about OCC lip tars. And I was just watching Chelsea Wears and she was talking about them and it reminded me, so I leapt up to make it. So I haven't done anything with my hair or my makeup's pretty. Anyway, so you'll forgive me for looking a little casual. It's a Sunday afternoon and I've got the house mostly to myself, so I thought I would take advantage of the time. So what I'm going to do is make a lip balm base and then I'm going to mix in lip tar colors, and so that I'll have like colored lip balms, and just to make them more portable, more usable for me. I love the lip tars, but from the fun of playing with color aspect, but they're really drying and they're not very portable because they make a mess. You need a brush. I just don't take them out with me. If I apply them, then I usually end up just applying something else over them later in the day. So I'm going to show you what I'm doing. Okay, so we're in my kitchen and I've got all my lip balm ingredients out. I started out first by making myself a little palette just on a paper plate. These are all the colors of the lip tars that I own. I've got Not Safe for Work, Queen, Strumpet, Memento, Melange, Hush, and Interlace. I don't expect you to be able to read my handwriting. And so I started playing on another plate and just came up with some color combos that I like. This is Strumpet plus Interlace, Hush plus Queen, Melange plus Not Safe for Work, Memento plus Strumpet, and Memento plus Not Safe for Work. So other things I have, I've already weighed out all my ingredients for my lip balm. And here are my basic fixings right here. The basic recipe that I use, and again, sorry about my terrible handwriting, it's 25% coconut oil, and I just have some nice organic coconut oil from Trader Joe's. 25% beeswax. This I got at a place in Seattle called Zenith Supplies, but there's a million places where you can get beeswax. This is nice because it doesn't come in a big chunk. It's in these little beads, so they melt really quickly. If you get a big chunk, you need to be patient. I've got some almond oil that I also picked up at Zenith Supply, just a little 2-ounce bottle of that. Shea butter, cocoa butter, and some castor oil. A lot of these things you can find at the health food store. Also, I was kind of chuckling to myself when I was making, this is 2 ounces of shea butter. I paid $4 for it. If you go into like La Citane, I think you pay something extortionate. I don't know, like $15 or something for like a 1/2 ounce of pure shea butter. And here it is, $4. So hit up your health food stores, or there's a million sources online for these sorts of supplies. I've also got some lip balm tubes that I purchased at Zenith. Again, you can find these at a lot of places online, and I believe I listed resources on my other lip tar video. I've already cleaned these with a little rubbing alcohol. And then I have these little tubs that I was going to use that I got just at an art supply store. They have those little plastic lids that I thought would work also as like a lip balm tub. And I've also cleaned these with alcohol. So, and I've got a little pot going on the stove with some water. I've got my ingredients inside of a poach pot, or like just a little silicone container. You know, obviously you need something that's heat proof. Unfortunately, I'm probably going to end up getting this kind of discolored if I mix the lip tars in here. I was thinking of just making a bunch of the lip balm base and then dividing it up and coloring it from there. But if you have a metal spouted measuring cup, that's excellent for this sort of thing. I just don't have one any longer. I used to use one, especially with pour. It'll be a challenge to pour the lip balms without a little spout, but I'm hoping since this is flexi, I'll be able to pour them without making too much of a mess. But I had an old one from IKEA that was excellent for making lip balm. So I'm going to put this into the double boiler and we're just going to wait for that to melt. Okay, you can see everything's all melted here. It's all nice and clear. There are no chunks anymore. And so now I'm going to pour them into the pots I prepared. Okay, I'm getting ready to pour. Strong word of caution here. Remember, what we're taking out here is
very hot wax and oil, and it will be painful if you get it on your skin, so just be careful not to touch it. Remember that the container is very hot, so you know, use a towel or something to hold it. Also, these silicone things are very, very flexy and floppy, so just be cautious, and hopefully I won't make too huge of a mess. The nice thing when you're doing this, if you accidentally spill some somewhere and you wipe it up, you can use your hands to wipe it up, and it's very moisturizing. I'm gonna get a little bit more on here, and I better start stirring this into those pigments before it starts to solidify too much. I wasn't really sure how much pigment to put in these, so I just kind of squished it in there as a guesstimation, but it's looking like I've got fairly good color in these. Of course, I'm sorry, I'm blocking it with my hand. Difficult to stir these little pots without grabbing onto them. Hopefully you can see a little bit there of what I'm doing. Does that make it better? Yes. Yeah, these are already starting to set up a little bit. You know, it is still winter time if you were doing this in a warmer climate or in warmer weather, you'd have a lot more open time. But you could always, you know, just warm these back up and get everything all back in play again. All right, I think those look pretty good. If you're extremely impatient and want to see these right away, you could put these in the fridge to cool a little faster, but they'll cool down and become solid at room temperature fairly quickly on their own. All right, the next thing I was gonna do is take the remains and color them all with the strumpet, which is definitely my favorite one, and I am just gonna wing it in terms of how much color to put in here. That's probably tons more than I need. And just disperse all that color in there. Whew. Oh Lord, that's pretty. I think I mentioned in my original video, I like to use the strumpet as a cheek color too. It's just a really gorgeous cheek tint there. All right, so got my strumpet all stirred up here, and I'm gonna do one lip balm tube of all strumpet. So I'll just show you pouring into the tube. It's just as simple as it sounds. You really just take it and pour it right in. You want to get all the water off the bottom of the container so that doesn't drip in. You don't have to worry about preservatives with lip balms because there is no water content, so it is good to keep the water out as much as possible because that is where bacteria likes to grow. There we go. I'm gonna put that back on the heat. It's starting to set up a little bit. So there's one lip balm tube poured. If you get serious about making lip balm, they do make little racks. You can put these in also, like what's going to happen, actually you can already see it happening, is as this cools and all the air bubbles come out, it'll start to sink and you'll get kind of a divot in the center. If you're making these for sale, usually you like to come and do a second pour so you get a nice rounded top. But since this is for personal use, I don't really care, and I'm just gonna leave it as is and set this aside to cool. Okay, so since I'm just making this up as I go along, I think I'm gonna try mixing this next one just in the tube, because basically what I want is a strumpet with just a tiny bit of the interlace color. Interlace is this great pinky nude. And I think I'm just going to add one drop, two, let's go crazy, and stir it up with my toothpick Let's see what kind of color that gives me. Got to work quickly because this is really starting to set up. Of course, it's not going to be the same color consistently through the tube. Stir, stir, stir. Okay, definitely not ideal setup to mix in the tube, but like I said, this is just for little old me, so if it's a bit messy, so be it. I know it looks like a total mess, but I still think it's a really pretty color, though. Do a little swatch of that. That's some seriously pretty lip color there. I've got the rest of my strumpet, and I've mixed it with Memento, and I'm going to put it in my final tube I've got here, hopefully without making a mess. Oops. All right. Still got a little bit more, so I'll have to find another container to get that into. I'll just leave it in the water so it doesn't set up. But that is all there is to it.
Okay, so thanks for joining me through that. I hope I demystified making your own cosmetics at home a little bit. I know this wasn't a very sophisticated batch. I'll post the recipe in the comments below, but if you go online, you will find thousands of recipes for lip balm online, and everybody likes theirs a little different. This is a recipe that I developed years ago that I felt really strongly resembled the Burt's Bees, so it is quite emollient and very glossy. If you want something, you know, different, you can obviously look around. If you wanted to flavor your lip balm, you can purchase flavor oils online. You could also use, I used to just use a little bit of peppermint essential oil to mimic the Burt's Bees as well. You want to be extremely sparing with that, like really one drop. That's all you need. The lip tars also do seem to have some peppermint essential oil in them already. And I'm not really doing this for the flavor. I'm just doing it to play with the color. So I'm not worried about that. I think that's everything. I'm going to insert also some photos taken in good lighting. I know it's dark and I'm under indoor lighting here. But that is it. And I hope that was interesting to you. And I will talk to you again soon. Hey, one final note. So now that these have cooled a little bit, I've been able to test them on my hand, and I can see I was a little hesitant with the color, so they're not as strong as I'd like. Right now, they're just sort of like a really light tinted balm. Well, some of them, the strumpet ones are, I went a little more gung-ho with the color, so those have a deeper color. So I may end up remelting these and adding a little bit more color, or just keeping these and then doing it again with a more intense color, but just so you know. And then it's getting dark here. Maybe I will take some photos of the results that I got in some daylight. And if I get a chance to do that, I'll include them in the description bar down below. So once again, goodbye and thanks for watching.